So that's what you meant when you said they turned into trees. We need to find something to defrost the office door. Mallor could still be in there. Is this Director Mallor? I've seen a lot of things in my career, but this... We need to figure out who's turning people into plants. I'll collect evidence linking Mallor to the animal abduction. You try finding an authorization card and look at the recordings from the local surveillance cameras.
That's Liz, the activist I met in Dr. Finch's van. She's the one who attacked us in the Keeper's house and turned people into trees.
I know her. It's Liz. She used to work as a guide in the park, but she quit because she disagreed with Mallor. I don't understand how or why she's doing this to people, but at least now I know who's responsible. She still lives in Tree Hill City. I'll take you there, and on the way, I'll order them to release Tina and put Liz on our most wanted list. Someone damaged the car. I'll fix the engine. Will you try to patch the tire? I saw glue in Mallor's office near the broken aquarium.
The suspect was spotted in the Elm Street area, but we've lost contact. The patrol car isn't responding.
I'm heading over there, and I'll pick up Tina on the way. Here's Liz's house. Maybe you can find some clues there. Contact me if you figure out her next move.
This little forest dweller was a favorite of the children of Tree Hill, and often came to play with them. Sometimes, they even gave him treats. Unfortunately, the streets of Tree Hill looked empty that day, and the air was unusually cold for that time of year. Liz, a woman the bear cub remembered well, was walking down the street. She'd always been kind and given him treats. She'd even clean up garbage while walking in the woods. But this time she was surrounded by ominous smoke, and as soon as she looked at other people, they turned into motionless plants. The city was in a panic, and people hurried to hide from Liz's anger. The bear cub tried to find a place to hide. But as soon as he reached somewhere secluded, he slipped and fell into a mountain of garbage, the kind Liz had struggled with so much.
Oh.
She wants to turn everyone on the planet into plants. I have to find out where she went. Maybe there's a clue in her diary.
Amanda, I'm okay. Sheriff Terla told me everything. Were you able to figure out her plans?
Of course, I know that place. It's Hyperion, the tallest tree on the planet. We can get there in no time.
I hope we're not too late. The artifact's power increases with each piece that's collected. There's no telling how much damage it could do. Oh, no. She's gotten to the Keeper.
I understand you don't want to admit the obvious, but pollution across the world is out of control. Our entire ecosystem is under threat. There's only one way to stop this madness and save the natural world.
Amanda, this is our last chance. You have to take the artifact from her.
Thank you.
You can't stop me. I'll take your amulet and finish what I started. The world will slumber and wake up cleansed.
Those who were transformed returned to normal and went back to their everyday lives. And tourists appeared in Redwood again to admire its beauty. The perpetrators were punished, and the park once again became a haven for all its inhabitants. The new administration, headed by Dr. Amanda Jones, closely monitored human activity in the park to ensure it didn't harm the environment. Who knows what other secrets this forest might hold, and whether some of them are better left a mystery.